and welcome to another video with me, Elmo J. Karjalainen. You can call me this guy or that guy or whatever guy if my name is tricky to pronounce. It's good to have you along. Today I'm taking a look at the Bugera T50 Infinium tube amp, valve amp, and I'll be right back after this intro. So, like I said, today I'm taking a look at the Bugera T50 Infinium. It's 50 watts of tube power. It costs just under 300 euros, which is nothing for a 50 watt amp. It has, well, I have to actually check it. It has four 12AX7 tubes and two EL34s in the power section. It has two channels, it's switchable, class A or AB operation. It comes with gain, treble, mid, bass, reverb, tone cut, volume, and a fat switch. So it has separate EQ controls for the separate channels, whereas the master section, reverb, and all that is shared. I don't think there's too much else to say at this point. Let's just try it out. Okay, so I'm using a custom mahogany Strat with Seymour Duncan YJM Fury pickups. They're stacked humbuckers, so they kind of fall somewhere in between regular single coils and humbuckers. I also have an overdrive pedal, which I'll be using at some point. It's the Mosky D250 overdrive, which is a clone of the slightly more famous Dodd. It's kind of cheap knockoff Yngwie Malmsteen overdrive. I thought I'd use a very cheap overdrive because it's a very cheap amp. So kind of, if this works, it could be a really budget-friendly way for you to get a good sound. But let's try clean first, then I'll try the overdrive channel, slightly crunchy, and see how much gain it does, and then try it with a pedal. I also have a bit of delay going on, and this is the clean sound with EQ everything set halfway. So that's the clean sound with everything set halfway. Actually, the reverb that you heard was from the amp and I didn't have delay engaged quite yet. Okay, let's see what the clean channel sounds like with an overdrive pedal. I have to drop volume a bit because this is going to get a bit loud. I also have a noise gate because the overdrive makes a bit of a noise. Okay, here goes. Okay, that's the clean channel with overdrive. Let's go over to the overdrive channel. Okay, so I have this one set up so that EQ, again, everything is roughly halfway. I find that that's kind of a good starting point if you're unsure, and then you can tweak if you feel like tweaking. I have gain just under halfway, and I have the low cut button at halfway. So let's just start by seeing what that does. Sorry, I said low cut, I meant tone cut. Thank you. tone cuts all the way down. Don't think it did a whole lot. Let's turn it all the way opposite. Okay, I'll just turn that back halfway. Yeah, so let's check out a bit of crunchiness from this amp. I'll just turn off the delay. Let's see what it thinks of an overdrive, because this is roughly the kind of breakup that I would have in the Plexi, and I would use something like a Fender Ingve overdrive to get it kind of going, kind of what most people would describe as high gain. I don't think of it as high gain because I think it sounds very, very different to a high gain amp. But this is the amount of breakup that I would normally have. So the Mosky D250. I'll try tweaking this a bit. I'll add a bit of mids, drop a bit of treble, see what it thinks of life now. Okay, that made it much better, but the starting point was quite poor, so I'm not sure how good you can make this by tweaking. Let's see, I'll add a bit more mid, maybe a bit of bass. I dropped the top end a bit as well because I didn't like that. Didn't like what the tone cut did to the top end though, so I'm not gonna touch that. What happens when you get thirsty mid-lick for a bit of tea? It's not terrible. There's some aspects I like. Let's see how what happens when you add a bit of gain. I'm stopping. I won't use the overdrive pedal anymore. So gain just over halfway. I'm watching my meters and they start peaking because now there's a ton of bass going on. Still the same thing. Added a bit of treble because this is a bit muddy. Okay, because it's so boomy and so bassy already with bass just halfway, just under halfway, I'm hesitant to even try the fat switch, but let's give it a go. That's about it, actually. What are the pros? I thought the clean was okay. I thought it handled the pedal quite okay. You could tweak it to be quite nice with the pedal and a bit of crunch. But the top end was really harsh. I didn't like what the tone cut knob did to the top end, even though it cut away the top end, which was annoying. It just kind of turned everything to mush. In general, I didn't really like the sound of the amp. I mean, even though it had some okay sounds in it, I think there are way better sounds out there, which you can get if you just put another $100, kind of raise your budget, another $100. 300 is nothing for a valve amp or a tube amp. That's 50 watts. It's absolutely nothing. Personally, I'm not really sure what I would go for because I'm not really sure what this amp does, if you know what I mean. I mean, it's not a plexi type thing. It doesn't really do the high gain stuff. It kind of, I don't know what it's supposed to be. I did try to look up what it's supposed to be online before I did this video, but I wasn't able to instantly find anything. And while I was looking, I kind of thought maybe it's better if I don't, because then I won't have any preconceived notions. The bad thing is that I was hoping that it would kind of say something to me, and it doesn't say anything to me. Okay, yeah, it's kind of meh, kind of like that. And if I were you, I'd save my 300 and just get something better when you've saved up a bit. That being said, if you do need a 50 watt tube head or valve head kind of now, and you don't have money to spare, then this might be an option. Although, even in that case, I'd look at the second-hand market for something else. Because this just doesn't do it for me. Even with the overdrive pedal, not too sure about this. The top end was where the bees lived, and the bottom end was terribly boomy when you use the gain from the actual amp. Now at €300, $300-something, I wouldn't trust this amp live. Not that I basically trust anything live. I usually have a spare of almost everything, except for a cab maybe, because that's so big. But still, this I would definitely not trust live. I've heard bad things of the old Bugera line, but the Infinium line is supposed to be better. But I've heard some bad things said about those as well. I'm not sure how trustworthy these bad things are, these bad reports, but I do know that the Bugera 1960 Infinium that I had, that I demoed, which I liked, but I ended up selling it because I already have two plexis. I ended up selling it, and the new owner had it for a month, and it lit up like a Christmas tree, and all the lights were flashing, and then it said nothing. It's just one amp. You can't draw conclusions from one amp, but then again, kind of fits my preconceived notion of these amps. Cheap often means that corners have been cut. I'm not saying that corners have definitely been cut, but I would definitely be suspicious and get two of these if I was to gig live. So that's basically my two cents. I hope you liked the video. Give it a thumbs up if you did. Give it a thumbs down if you didn't. Comment, let me know what you thought, and let me know if you've had any experience with this particular amp, especially reliability issues. Subscribe if you haven't already, hit that bell notification thing, and support me on Patreon, because I buy the gear that I review so you get an honest review. And in this case, I'm just gonna say, save your money, get something else at another time when you have more money. And if you have a bigger budget, don't even look at this thing, get something else. And when you support me on Patreon, you also get a bunch of exclusives, like a live album that's not available anywhere else, and an album that's not been released anywhere else apart from on Patreon. So do check that out. You also get to choose 5 of my songs, and I'll make a personalized live in the studio, in this setting, live in the studio thing for you on DVD, burn it and send it to you free of charge. That will be available January and February of 2020. So if you sign up after that, then something else will probably be happening. And if you want free music, check out my website. The link's in the description. That's all I have for you today. It was good having you along. I hope to see you in another one. Take care. Goodbye.